So, we started there with the Church's One Foundation, a really fantastic hymn, one of my favourites, with a little bit of last verse reharmonisation there by Noel Rawstorm. The tune is called Aurelia. We're going to go into Love Divine, or Love's Excelling, Joy of Heaven to Earth Come Down, not to the tune Blind Worm, but to the tune Love Divine by John Stainer. This is requested by Derek Horn, who quite simply says, let's have this tune for a change. Next up is Come Down, O Love Divine, the wonderful tune Down Ampney by Vaughan Williams. Come down, O Love Divine, seek thou this soul of mine and visit it with thine own ardour glowing. O Comforter, draw near, within my heart appear and kindle it, thy holy flame bestowing. next tune to come in from Carmen Foster is "The Spacious Firmament on High with All the Blue Ethereal Sky and Spangled Heavens a Shining Frame, the great original proclaim," spaced out. The tune is called Addison's or London, in brackets. This took me a while to find this tune. I don't think there's a particularly common tune associated to these words. So I'll solo out the tune for verse one, and then, as usual, leave you to it from verse two. So, "The Spacious Firmament on High." Sorry that I'm not with you tonight, by the way. Live, that is. I'm actually enjoying a choir barbecue right now. So I hope you're chatting away as usual, and I hope you're enjoying the new angles. Please do pay attention to the Organ Festival, which is coming to a screen near you next week. Next up is "Jesu, the very thought of thee with sweetness fills my breast, but sweeter far thy face to see in all thy presence rest." The tune here is Saint Agnes. Now this is not the tune I associate with these words, simply because I was brought up with the New English Hymnal, and there's a tune in there which is not this tune. I forget what the tune is called, actually. Somebody will write it in the chat. But looking on Hymnary, for this hymn, it's very clear that this tune, if you take into account all of the hymn books printed and that are available on hymnary.org, this tune is by far the most popular. It appears that the NEH added the other tune of its own accord, and not many hymn books have that tune to it, which somebody will have printed in the live chat. So, as I say, this tune is called St. Agnes. And actually, it was requested by me. Now the next hymn made me do a double take when Greg requested it. I was there to hear your mourning cry, and I wasn't wearing these. And I thought Greg was requesting, I was there to hear your boring cry. And I thought, that can't possibly be right. But it is a mourning cry. I'll be there when you are old. I rejoiced the day you were baptized to see your life unfold. This is the first for a virtual church. It's brand new to me, and it goes a little bit like this. Next up is a really well-known tune, perhaps with less well-known words. Come, great God of all the ages, make your earthly mission known. Speak through every deed and person, let your way and will be shown. The tune is the very well-known Abbot's Leigh. And actually, interestingly, every version I could find of these words and this tune has the tune in C major. I could not find it in D major, as it's usually printed, and I thought, I'll transpose it up to D. But then I thought, no, there must be a reason why all of these hymn books are printing it in C. So let's see what it sounds like in the bright key of C major. Come, great God of all the ages.
Thank you.
next hymn is, I greet thee, whom my sure redeemer art, my only trust and saviour of my heart, who pain didst undergo for my poor sake, I pray thee from our hearts all cares to take. Now, the tune is called Toulon, and it's, I think this is quite a well-known tune, but the words are new to me. Is this a well-known hymn to you? Anyone watching, let me know in the chat, or if you're watching after the event, leave me a comment. The next hymn is a very simple, short hymn actually. Father, we love you, we worship and adore you, glorify your name in all the earth. Glorify your name, glorify your name, glorify your name in all the earth. And then the verse 2 is Jesus, we love you. And the verse 3 is Spirit, we love you. So those are the only words that change. This is by Donna Adkins. And it's, yeah, it's called Glorify Your Name. I want to use the clarinets down on the choir, verse 1, to solo out the tune. So this is a request from Glenn Snyder. Well, the next hymn, before we go into our top five hymns today, requested by one of our members of the community, is Blessed Jesus, at thy word we are gathered all to hear thee. Let our hearts and souls be stirred now to seek and love and fear thee. The tune is to the gorgeous Liebster Jesu, which J.S. Bach uses, of course, for his beautiful chorale arrangements of this tune. This is actually my request. I came across this and thought it'd be really fitting for today before we go into our top five hymns. And now for our top five hymns. These are lists prepared by you. If you want to send me your top five hymns and give me a reason why you've chosen those hymns, and also list the order. So from I'll start at number five and then go all the way to number one. Two sentences on each hymn as to why you've chosen that particular one. It could be sentimental, it could be you enjoy playing it, you like the tune, for whatever reason. Can't guarantee that I'll play them all of your lists, but I'll choose the ones with the most interesting context. So today's top five comes from a dear friend and supporter of Beauty and Sound, Paul Larson. I'm going to start at his fifth favourite hymn. It is For All the Saints Who From Their Labours Rest. And he says, one of the most picturesque hymns that he's ever played. As an organist, he found this hymn perfect for word painting throughout, and he thoroughly enjoyed doing so. So no pressure there, Paul. Let's have a go. So For All the Saints. Number four in Paul's list is All My Hope on God is Founded. And he says this, I've always found both the tune and the words very uplifting. I use this hymn as often as possible for Sunday services. This is probably the reason why he he is such a fan of Steve Richards' arrangement of this tune. A chance to plug the upcoming Call for Composers music publication. So, the tune is called Michael, and of course it's by Herbert Howells. All my hope on God is founded. Number three in Paul's list. This is what Paul says about it. See if you can work out what it is. Hearing the naval hymn always brings memories of my father. He served as a naval officer aboard the USS Yorktown, both during and in the years following the Korean War. I think the naval hymn there has given it away. It is, of course, Eternal Father, Strong to Save, to the tune Melita. This is number three in Paul's list.
Thank you.
So at number two in Paul's list is The Day Thou Gavest, Lord Is Ended, to the gorgeous tune St. Clement. And this is what Paul says: I can never hear this tune without having my mother come to mind. She frequently hummed it to me as a lullaby so long ago, is what Paul says. They sang it rather emotionally, I can imagine, at her funeral. So, The Day Thou Gavest, Lord, Is Ended. Which brings us on to Paul Larson's number one hymn. This is Paul's favourite hymn. And in fact, we've actually had these words, but we haven't had this tune. This made my list simply because I found it thrilling to play, is what Paul says. The tune is brilliant and all too often loved adding spontaneous ornaments in the pedal and melody lines. It is The Spacious Firmament on High to the tune Creation, which of course is a paraphrase of the Heavens Are Telling from Haydn's Creation. So Paul Larson's number one hymn is The Spacious Firmament on High to the tune Creation. And it sounds a little bit like this. Thank you. So thank you very much, Paul, for sending in your top five hymns. If you would like to send your top five hymns into Virtual Church, please send them to virtualchurch@beautyandsound.co.uk. Give me a good reason why you've requested each hymn, and the more interesting request is, there's more chance of it being chosen. You have to appreciate that. If I'm getting a dozen a week, I can't play a dozen top five lists. So with that, that brings us into our organ voluntary today, which is actually a request from Josh Wilson, celebrating his fourth wedding anniversary today. So congratulations, Josh, on 4 years. I'm sure you'll have many more 4 years. And Josh has requested a piece by Cargellert, which has been arranged for organ by Harold Jackson. It's called Praise the Lord with Drums and Cymbals. A very happy fourth anniversary to you, Josh. I hope that was okay. And that draws a close to this virtual church. I really hope that you've all enjoyed today's selection of hymns. Thank you very much to Paul Larson for submitting his top five hymns. Thank you for getting involved in the chat. Sorry I wasn't with you live, but I will certainly be looking back through the chat. If I'm not in the chat right now, Richard, am I in the chat? That's very strange. So I will see you a week tomorrow, week on Monday, for the start of the Beauty and Sound Summer Organ Festival. Look, it's on the screen there. There it is. Okay, you can't miss it. I've already announced the schedule program. So if you've missed that, where have you been? It's been on social media. It's been on Facebook. It's been on YouTube. It's been on Instagram. It's on all the. It's a really, really exciting lineup, and you wouldn't want to miss it. And I'm not just saying that, you wouldn't want to miss it. So until then, I will say a cheerio. Thanks everyone, take care, stay safe, and stay cool. Goodbye.